I think believing in a guy who walked on water and a guy who split at the sea is crazy. And they say to me, my religion is crazy, but yeah, what's the difference?
You can say a Pastafarian is not a true religion because it's based on the same grounds as every other religion. When you have a new religion, you have to fight for your rights.
The attorney for the man says his client is, quote, Pastafarian, and was denied his religious right as a member of the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monsters.
Hey everyone, Rick Hung here for Hollywood First Look Features. Today, I am here with director Michael Arthur for his film, I, Pastafari. Michael, I wanted to say congratulations. I found myself to be laughing a lot in this. At the same time, your film is very educational.
Yeah, thanks a lot. I mean, that was the intent. I mean, a lot of people see this and they think it's a comedy, but it's not. It's a documentary. It's a true story about a satirical religion, many people call it. So there are a few funny parts, but that's not why I made the film. I guess I just kind of got tired of this endless debate about religion's place in society. It always either ends with somebody saying, you got to just have faith, or somebody being condescending towards another person's personal beliefs. And that's not really the point. The point is to really reevaluate what role religion plays in our laws and our societies and how it dictates how we're allowed to treat other people, basically. So I made this film because, you know, the world is on two sides now. We're red or blue, liberal, conservative. We don't talk to each other. We just yell at each other. So I like the Pastafarian approach because they kind of trick you into critically thinking for yourself about some serious issues that are often just off the table when it comes to a debate. So that's why I decided to make the film.
So then something that stuck out in my mind watching this is this religion has tens and millions of followers. So I don't know when you jumped on, if you'd already known that or if that was like a fact that was revealed to you as you started doing interviews and research.
Yeah, no, I mean, I had always known about the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster. I live in Portland, Oregon, which is actually where it started. It wasn't until I moved to the Netherlands that I really got involved in and did a lot of research about what they were actually doing. That's the first thing people are really surprised about is how large it is. I mean, if you just go onto Facebook and just look for Flying Spaghetti Monster groups, you'll find groups in Poland with 100,000 people, Spain, Italy, basically every country across the world. And it's funny because, you know, it started kind of a satire about religion in order to point out that religion is not science, science is not religion, and when the two combine, they both suffer. But it's actually kind of turned into a religion itself. It's created a community of like-minded people who are gathering together to enact change in their societies. So I think it'll be interesting to see, you know, in a few, you know, 10, 20, 30, 100 years, if Pastafarianism isn't seen as a religion just like any other faith.
Well, speaking of being in the Netherlands, I was curious as you were doing this, how accessible were people that you interviewed? And even like you know, there's even footage of you being in the courtrooms. So I don't know if they were welcoming, like, you know, like the court system's welcoming, or even just some of the people that you interviewed to say, hey, I would like to interview you about this process. I don't know if that was as accessible or if it was like you had some hurdles there.
Yeah, no, I mean, initially, yes, there were some hurdles. People were really conspicuous of this American guy who lived in Europe asking them to talk about Pastafarianism. But I think once I kind of explained the point of the film, they saw that the point of the film aligned pretty much with the point of Pastafarianism. And so they welcomed me. And, you know, as far as the court system goes, different countries have different rules. Fortunately, the Netherlands allows public filming of all court cases. Germany does not, so you'll notice in the film, I'm not actually in the courtroom very much in Germany, but the Netherlands very much embraces, you know, this public discussion about law. Once I had something to show about what I was trying to do, that's all it really took for people to get on board. There were still a few I couldn't get. The prophet, Bobby Henderson, who started the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster with his open letter to the Kansas School Board in 2005. I couldn't get him to be a part of the film, unfortunately, but Bruder Spaghettis, Nico Wallm. These are some of the biggest figures in the pastafarian community, so I was pretty excited to get them involved.
So then what's the most, as you as a director, what was the most fascinating thing that you discovered in your interviews in the research that you had to say, I have to put this specifically in the film, or maybe you couldn't?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, some of the most interesting things for me were the actual cultural traditions that they're creating. So in the film, I capture a pastafarian wedding, which basically is a bunch of people dressed up in pirates, and they have all these, you know, songs and rituals that they do. I film a pastafarian service, faith service, called Noodle Mass. And the thing that really struck me after I filmed these things is that while it's all done for fun, it actually is creating religious traditions. They're kind of creating this religion as they go. And I thought that was fascinating. I did a lot of research. I read they have a gospel. They have a holy book. It's called The Gospel of the Flying Spaghetti Monster. But they also have a book called Loose Cannon, which was a collection of just hundreds of different pastafarian kind of quotes and memes and whatever that they gathered together and created a book. And it's hilarious because a lot of these things, you know, they're satire, but they also have meaning behind them.
Well, I wanted to tell you congratulations again. Thank you for telling the story. I feel like I'm almost halfway there if I wanted to actually explore being a pastafarian, because I have a colander. Nice. And I have a pirate hook as well. So
that's all you need. Yeah, the time to convert is now, man.
The film is I, Pastafari. It's available digitally July 7th. Until next time, I'm Rick Hong, and you've been watching Hollywood First Look Features.
All religions, they all have elements that are not very credible, not realistic. That's why it's called belief. You have to believe it, not explain it or rationalize it. If something looks like a religion, people say it is a religion, and people say they are adherents of this religion, it should be recognized as such.
The flying spaghetti monster not only deserves, but we mandate equal protection under the law. Our religion must be protected.